I'd like to call the 8th regular meeting of the City Common Council to get order. Would the clerk please call the roll?
Alderperson Ackley?
Here.
Alderperson Decker?
Here.
Alderperson Donahue?
Here.
Alderperson Feldy?
Here.
Alderperson Phillips?
Here.
Alderperson Spaglio?
Present.
Alderperson Sorensen?
Here.
Alderperson Felicki Pineski?
Here.
Alderperson Bourne? He's not dialed in yet. And Alderperson Mitchell said he was going to be excused tonight.
Mitchell is excused then. Would the clerk then please read the quote for the day?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Success in life hinges more on seizing opportunity than having everything go according to plan.
Thank you for that. And that's, please stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The next item on the agenda is approval of the minutes from our 7th council meeting held on July 6th and our 4th special council meeting held on July 10th. Alderperson Sorensen.
Thanks, Mr. Mayor. I move to approve the minutes from our previous meetings.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on those minutes? Seeing none, all those in favor of the motion, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. The next item on our agenda is a presentation of the restoration of our tree Sheboygan, known as Roots, by Tony Fessler of the Sheboygan Rotary Club. Tony?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Can you hear me?
Yes.
I'm not used to speaking through one of these masks, so we'll see if I make it through this.
You can pull the mic over a
little closer. Is that better?
Yep.
Okay, fine. And if you lose me somewhere along the line, let me know. First of all, I want to thank the mayor, his honor, and members of the council for allowing me to come and talk to you a little bit about the restoration of our tree Sheboygan project and perhaps related to some of the things we are trying to do with the city and throughout the county here. I'll give you a presentation for perhaps 10 or 12 minutes, and then I'll open it to questions. If any of the members of the council or others have questions, we'll try to address them. I am not an arborist, but fortunately, Tim Bull, your city forester, is here and can deal with the technical questions, I would assume. And before I get started, I also want to introduce Scott Litke, who is the president of the Sheboygan Rotary Club, and along with a number of other Rotarians, has been instrumental in helping me put this project together and getting it off the ground. Essentially, this project that I'm speaking to tonight and the benefits for the city started about 2 years ago when the Sheboygan Rotary Club and a second Rotary Club in Sheboygan, the so-called Early Birds Rotary Club, came together to work with Joe Curlin, your superintendent of parks, with regard to trying to do some planting with the city. And I got put in a committee and was introduced to the scope of an environmental problem that I knew existed, but I don't think I appreciate it fully. And that is the infestation of the emerald ash borer, which I'm sure this body is generally quite familiar with at this point. I worked with Joe and the public works staff and the park staff over a period of time. The two Rotary clubs raised resources that weren't available to the city to plant a total of about 140 trees, and that was in celebration of the city's 40th anniversary of it being the Tree City USA and the oldest city in the state that had had that remarkable honor bestowed upon it. So we were able to raise $14,500 to assist the city in planting 140 trees in parks and on the streets here in the city of Sheboygan, But during that period of time, Joe Curlin and the city staff really educated me to the scope of the Emerald Ash Borer problem and the devastation it was presenting to the city of Sheboygan, and obviously well beyond the city itself throughout the county. And at one or two points during our meeting, I asked Joe whether the city was alone in this effort. Obviously, there's some county involvement and state involvement. And I asked whether the private sector was at all engaged in this effort to try to deal with this environmental threat. And the answer, quite frankly, is the city was pretty much by itself, along with some county and state help, but that the private sector wasn't stepping up to the plate at that point. And it seemed to me as a Rotarian that Rotary can play a role here in helping not only the city of Sheboygan, but communities throughout the area in trying to bring forward private resources that weren't then being presented. Now, I'm old enough, probably older than most of you in this room, to remember the Dutch elm disease of the 1950s and 1960s. That devastated what had been the city of Elms. The city of Sheboygan was known as the city of Elms by, of course, a destruction of many of the beautiful elm trees that we had. But the response to that was not just a city or a county response at that time. It was a response involving the private sector as well. And it seemed to me that it was time for someone to stand up and to be supportive of what the municipality here in Sheboygan and those municipalities elsewhere in the county were doing. So I was able to prevail on the Rotary Club in Sheboygan to allow me to go forward and put together a project that eventually came to be known as Restoration of Our Trees Sheboygan, or Roots. You have to have an acronym for what you're doing. And we began the process of working with an environmental organization, a network, if you would, in eastern part of Wisconsin that is known as the Lakeshore Natural Resource Partnership, which is already working with the city on a number of other projects. But we came together and formed an MOU in partnership with LNRP to try to put together a strategy that we thought might make a difference in helping not only this municipality, but others throughout the county. So over the period of the late part of 2018 and early 2019, we put an MOU together with LNRP, and there were three legs to it, and I'm going to principally look at one of those with you, one part of our strategy this evening, which impacts on the city, but there were three aspects of it. First of all, we wanted to get out and do some public education. The city certainly and the county were doing some things, but this really isn't your role, it seems to me, in terms of public education and public outreach. So we got together and worked with the Maywood Environmental Center and some other educational institutions in the area to try to begin to educate the public overall as to this environmental threat. We've done that in some workshops we've run through Maywood. We hope to do some more with the public education system here throughout the county. Frankly, we're being slowed in the effort right now because of the COVID-19 and the inability to get people together, but we're trying to do more virtually on that. But that was one part of our strategy. The second part was we realized that there was an absence of resources to do forest management and forestry planning. Now, we're well along because of Tim and Joe and the others here in the city with that process in the city of Sheboygan. And the larger municipalities in the county are well along as well because there's some resources there and expertise. Where we're not doing very well is in the townships. And so the Department of Natural Resources in the end of 2018 awarded us a modest grant to begin to work actively with the townships throughout the county. And we are now well along in that process. We're using volunteers. We're using technical expertise from LNRP and also from the DNR in order to work with the townships to begin to build a database and to begin to collect data on the resources, principally ash resources that are out there and that will be lost to this devastation. I didn't mention it earlier, but just to give you a scope of what we're up against here, probably on the order of over one third of the street and park trees in Sheboygan are ash, and they'll all be lost to this EAB infestation before we're done. In the next 5 or 10 years, you'll lose it all. So as you all go home tonight, take a look at the tree canopy and realize that about one out of every three of those trees you see is an ash and it's about to be lost. That's why something needs to be done about this if we're going to preserve the canopy. And overall in the county, over 17 million trees are ash trees. Some townships, like the town of Sheboygan, for example, the percentage of ash is much higher. It's as high as 70% ash in the town of Sheboygan. And if you drive into that area, think about what that's going to look like in 5 or 10 years. So the second leg in this effort then was to bring some resources into this for actual planning. And as I said, that process is underway. Again, COVID-19 has made it somewhat complicated to train our volunteers and get them out there. I talked to the DNR within the last couple of hours and their understanding of the challenges that COVID is representing to us, but they've been very accommodating, allowing us to go forward. They've renewed and extended that grant this past year, and we're now up to a grant of about $50,000 that is being used for urban forestry planning. But the real element to the strategy that I wanted to address with you this evening is what we call our Community Investment Fund, which is a fund that seeks private capital from industry, from business, and from large foundations that have the means to do so, that go into the Sheboygan County Rotary Foundation, a 501c3 organization, that then we're going to make available and are making available to municipalities here in Sheboygan on a matching basis in order to accelerate the level of replanting of trees and the removal of ash trees that, of course, are a part of the problem here. We're well along in that process. We've raised resources both from the public sector. The U.S. Forest Service a year ago granted us $200,000 for Sheboygan County that is essentially focused on mitigation of emerald ash borer. And we're the only county in all of Wisconsin right now that has had the benefit of that large grant coming to us. So it's a unique thing. It's happened because of what Roots is doing. And some of that $200,000 resources will be made available to the city of Sheboygan and to municipalities. We've already dedicated some of those resources to mitigation in Esslingen Park that you're familiar with just west of the city, Gerber Lake out in the neighborhood of Lakeland University, and the Sheboygan Marsh, which is almost exclusively ash. So the mitigation there will be underway, and by mitigation I mean the removal of ash trees and the planting of non-ash replacement trees. Again, COVID-19 has slowed up our ability to bring in some of the contractors that we want to, but we're at least in the stage where we will dedicate those resources. Specifically this evening, and there's a resolution you'll be voting on later, the other aspect of our third level of strategy, or a third leg here, is the private money that we have raised in the Sheboygan area. It's still a modest amount, but it's enough for us to go forward with 5 demonstrator projects. 2 of those projects involve the city of Sheboygan, and we're hoping that you will allow us to move forward with the adoption of a resolution a little bit later this evening. Each of the Sheboygan-based Rotary Clubs is offering resources to the city of Sheboygan. The Roots Fund itself, which offers additional Rotary resources, will be available for 2 sets of projects. And then we have the assistance of the Alliant Energy Company that is making a corporate donation of about $5,000 to further support this effort. So what we're bringing to the city, and with a lot of help from Tim and from Joe Curlin, who helped put the plan together, are 2 separate mitigation plans involving a total of 6 city parks. It will accelerate mitigation in Lakeview Park, you're familiar with that, on the south side of Sheboygan, the Rotary Park right down along the water area itself, and Area 5 of the Evergreen Park, which of course gets tremendous use on the part of many in the community for recreational purposes, public meetings. That work will be done with the support of the Sheboygan Rotary Club and the Alliant Energy Company, and also with a district grant from the Rotary organization. And 3 additional parks then will be supported in a mitigation effort by the Early Bird Rotary Club. That'll be Roosevelt Park, Cleveland Park, and Veterans Park. And they're also going to be part of the effort on Area 5 of Evergreen Park. So all told, we're stepping up to the plate to work with the city of Sheboygan to accelerate mitigation in those six parks. I want to tell all of you that you've got a tremendous staff here, if you don't already know it, you probably do, with Joe Curlin and Tim Bull, who have been instrumental in putting these projects together. They've been highly responsive, and I can't say enough for the city staff and the cooperation we've had. I won't go into the details of the other three projects, but just I'll cover them very quickly and say that we've got one project going with the city of Sheboygan Falls to mitigate in the so-called River Park area, if you're familiar with that, and a access point to River Park. We'll be doing that project, and the County Stewardship Fund has come forward to help the Rotary organization assist in funding the city of Sheboygan Falls in that project. We also have approval now to go forward with a project for four parks and mitigation of four parks in Plymouth. That again is being done with the assistance of the Plymouth Utilities Organization, and again with Rotary District money and with Rotary money we brought to this effort through Roots. So that project will go forward later this summer. And finally, we're out and working with the village of Elkhart Lake and a modest program out there involving two parks and a number of street areas. So all told, we have a lot going on with these demonstrator projects. I would simply, before I open myself to questions, I would ask for the council members that are here present tonight and those that are, of course, virtually with us, if we could look for your support, first of all, for the resolution tonight. And secondly, as Roots goes forward, we're going to be continuing to knock on private sector doors, corporate Sheboygan County, and also large foundations with means, so that we can, if you would, if I may use an old Navy term, I'm a naval officer of 23 years, retired, to use an old Navy term, we are really trying to get all hands on deck here for a whole of community effort to combat this problem. We believe the council knows it's a problem, and I know you've dedicated additional resources to the public works staff and the park staff. We would ask you to continue supplementing that support, which is going to be necessary in the next several years when the devastation becomes ever more apparent. And while you do that, Roots and the private sector will step up to the plate, but anything you can do to help us raise money in the private sector would be greatly welcomed as we go forward. We hope to have a project that really winds itself up in another 2 to 3 years. We want to make an impact, to use an old military term of mine. I'm calling this a surge effort. You've heard about the surge in Afghanistan and Iraq. Well, this is a surge for Sheboygan County, but it's in an environmental war that we're engaged in. We want to put resources on this problem quickly. We want to do this for future generations. I don't have to tell you that it makes a difference in terms of not so much those of us who are present tonight, but our children and our grandchildren who will enjoy this tree canopy if we can maintain it. The advantages are tremendous. Aesthetically, it's an advantage. Offers, of course, the city of Sheboygan benefits in terms of its tax base, quite frankly, because it's a demonstrated fact that tree canopies help with property values, public and private. And the other thing I guess I would point out is that it obviously helps with the effort of global warming, removes CO2 from the air, and obviously pollutants as well. So there are many benefits to maintaining a healthy tree canopy, economic, ecological, and otherwise. With that, Mr. Mayor and members of the council, thank you for your time and attention. And if you have any questions, I'll try to field them. Again, if they're technical, I'm going to ask Tim to bail me out.
Tony, thank you so much for your presentation. Are there any questions, Mr. Fessler? Hearing none, I want to thank you very much as an organization and individual for seeing a problem and trying to find a way to fix it, and you're doing a great job. Thank you.
Thanks, Mr. Mayor, and we'll stay with it. We're going to be here, and this is not the only project that we're going to be doing for the city of Sheboygan as we go forward. Thank you.
Thank you. Next,
Mayor.
Go ahead.
This is Ryan. Jim Bourne is on the phone. He called my cell. He wasn't able to join the GoToMeeting app. So I don't know if he can vote through my phone through my end, if that's okay. But he's on speaker.
Well, we will try to reach him again, and if nothing else works, then that will be fine.
Okay.
Next, we'll move on to mayor's appointments, city attorney.
So we have one set of appointments from the mayor to the members of the Common Council as a result of the resignation of Todd Wolf from the Common Council, submitting the following appointments for your confirmation. The Finance and Personnel Committee, Roberta Flicky-Pineski. To the Public Works Committee, moving Dean Decker to the chair position and adding Betty Ackley. To the Transit Commission, Dean Decker. To the Board of Marina, Parks and Forestry, Dean Decker. To the Mayor's International Committee, Betty Ackley. And to the Redevelopment Authority, Trey Mitchell.
Thank you very much. Those appointments will lie over till our next council meeting. City Clerk, do we have anything for public forum?
Not this evening, Your Mayor.
Thank you. Next will be Mayor's announcements. Thank you. I'd like to ask Police Officer Jeffrey Mars to step forward. Officer Jeffrey Mars grew up in New London, Wisconsin, and graduated from Clintonville High School in 1985. Jeff then attended Carthage College and graduated with a Bachelor of Arts degree in Criminal Justice and Sociology. Jeff then entered the Law Enforcement Academy of Fox Valley Technical College and graduated on August 31st of 1990. Jeff began his employment with the city of Sheboygan as a police officer on January 27th of 1992. Over the past 28 and a half years, Jeff has been an active member of the department and served as a field training officer, emergency vehicle operations instructor, a firearms instructor, an evidence technician, a dive club member, an emergency response team member, and a police explorer advisory. In 2012, the department transitioned from field training officer model of training to new officers to a police training officer program. Jeff again volunteered and was selected to be a police training officer, largely because of his passion for training and patience as and expertise as a teacher. In his off time, Jeff has served as for a long time as a police academy instructor at Lake Shore Technical College. Officer Mars was assigned to the Crime Prevention Unit in January of 1996 and worked as a community policing officer until 1999. Jeff finished out his career by being selected as a Northside beat officer, and in this position, he has strengthened the relationship between the police department and the residents of the north side of the city, helping to establish additional neighborhood associations, and he's assisted other officers with problem solving in their neighborhoods. During his career, Jeff received numerous commendations. He has blessed us with strong communication skills, a positive attitude, and a drive to make others better. I'm grateful for his service to the city of Sheboygan and wish him all the best in retirement. Jeff, we have a certificate of appreciation that we'd like to present you, and it reads, Certificate of Appreciation, the City of Sheboygan is honored to present to Jeffrey Mars and for his 28 years of dedicated service from January 27th of 1992 to August 1st of 2020. Jeff, congratulations and have a great retirement.
Thank you so much.
At our last council meeting, we held a moment of silence on the passing of Valentine Schultz, who served as an alderperson. And at this time, I'd like to read the resolution that'll be up for vote tonight. A resolution commemorating the distinguished service of Valentine Schultz to the city of Sheboygan. Whereas God in his divine wisdom has called from this life our valued friend and fellow person, former alderperson, Valentine Schultz, Sr. Whereas Val Schultz served the residents of the city of Sheboygan as an alderperson in the 5th District for many years from 1990 to 2003. And whereas during his tenure as an alderperson, Mr. Schultz served as a valuable member of numerous council committees, including Judiciary and Legislative, the Board of Contract Examiners, Industrial Development Commission, the Finance Committee, Public Protection and Safety Committee, Capital Improvements, the Transit Commission, Salaries and Grievances, Industrial Development Commission, Redevelopment Authority, the City Planning Commission, the Board of Heating Examiners, Special Marina Commission, and President of the Common Council from 1997 to 98, and Vice President of the Common Council from 1996 to 97. And whereas Mr. Schultz served his constituents in the city of Sheboygan faithfully and honorably, being a man of outstanding ability and integrity, and whereas Mr. Schultz was a valuable member of the City Council and committees upon which he served, always giving conscientious consideration to all matters which came before him for legislation, and with an open mind, putting honesty and charity before all else, he will always be a good example to all, and therefore be it resolved that the City of Sheboygan Common Council go on record in their deep sorrow and offering his family their deepest sympathy. Whereas Val Schultz passed away on July 1st of 2020, now therefore be it resolved that the Common Council hereby commemorates the distinguished service rendered by Mr. Val Schultz to the city of Sheboygan throughout his many years of service and expresses its sorrow to his of his passing and offers to his wife Suzanne and their entire family its deepest sympathy. Be it further resolved that this resolution is to be published in this council's official proceedings and that a suitable copy be presented to the family of Valentine Schultz. And last, I'd like to give a COVID-19 update. Just want to review the numbers for today. As of today, we had 418 positive cases. That's up 97 from last week, where we had 321. We have 127 active cases, and that's up 36 from 91 of last week. We have 285 cases that have recovered. That's up 59 from 226 of last week. We maintained only two people in the hospital both weeks. And unfortunately, we had one additional death this week, so that brings our total deaths from four up to five. There's been over 14,683 tests administered, and that's up from last week by another 1,941. And the cases have increased slightly in their prevalence. The percentage of positive cases to tests done increased from 2.5% to 2.84%. The Sheboygan County Public Health officials released the Sheboygan County Safe Restart Recommendation Plan to reopen that included strong controls for businesses and residents. We continue to be in phase two of this plan that says that businesses open, they need to follow the Economic Development Corporation's best practices and sanctions specific to their sector. The Meade Public Library this week opened up their children's department to the public with limited hours. The entire Meade Library is open on Monday through Fridays from 10 to 6 and Saturdays 10 to 2. The Meade Library and other city buildings, including City Hall, have also instituted a mandatory mask policy to enter the buildings, and masks will be provided if needed. As the COVID-19 numbers have dramatically increased, the food truck gathering that has taken place at Valrath Park is an event where very little social distancing has been practiced in the past, and this has caused concerns. Today, I ask that no parking signs to be placed on Valrath Boulevard and North 3rd Street at the food truck event. I have asked the vendors to put a plan together for how they can address the lack of social distancing at this gather to make it safer so it can come back. I was welcome to see many of the commercial businesses in our community and around the area taking action to require masks while shoppers conduct business in their facilities. It's good to see that they recognize the role that they can play to help protect the health and well-being of the community they serve by following the evolving guidance of health officials. Thank you. Next, we'll go on to the consent agenda. That'll include items 2.2 through 2.25. Alderperson Sorensen.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to receive and file all ROs, receive all RCs, and adopt all resolutions and ordinances.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on any of the items in the consent agenda? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Alderperson Filicki-Pineski. Roberta, are you on the call? Alderperson Bourne?
Please repeat that.
This is Alderman Bourne. Can you hear me?
Yes. Alderperson Bourne, how do you vote on the consent?
Aye.
Thank you.
We have 8 ayes.
Motion passes. Next, we'll move on to reports of officers. Those items 3.1 through 3.4 will be referred to various committees. Under resolutions, item 4.1 is resolution number 57 of 2021 by Alderperson Sorensen and Decker, authorizing that the fire chief to take all steps necessary to accept monies from the estate of Richard Neustadler in the amount of $400. Alderperson Sorensen.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to suspend.
Is there any objection to suspension? Seeing none, please proceed.
Thanks, Mayor. I move to adopt the resolution.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on the motion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Alderperson Bourne?
Aye.
Alderperson Filicki-Pineski?
Yes.
Nine ayes.
Motion passes. Item 4.2 is resolution number 58 of 2021 by Alderpersons Ackley, Donahue, Bourne, Savaglio, Filicki-Pineski, Feldy, Phillips, Sorensen, Mitchell and Decker, commemorating the distinguished service of Valentine Schultz to the city of Sheboygan. Alderperson Sorensen.
Thanks, Mayor. I move to suspend.
Second.
Is there any objection to suspension? Seeing none, please proceed.
Thanks, Mayor. Move to adopt the resolution.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. The clerk, please call the roll for passage.
Alderperson Bourne?
Aye.
Alderperson Filicki-Pineski?
Aye.
Nine ayes.
Motion passes unanimously. Items 3.3 and 3.4 will be referred to various committees. Under reports of committees, item 5.1 is an RC number 89 of 2021 by Finance and Personnel Committee, to whom was referred resolution number 47 of 2021 by Alderpersons Donahue and Borden, providing for the sale of approximately $4,615,000 of general obligation refunding bonds, series 2020C, recommends adopting the resolution. Alderperson Donahue.
Thank you. I move to receive the report of the committee and adopt the resolution.
Second, Bourne.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on that motion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Alderperson Bourne?
Aye.
Alderperson Flicky-Pineski?
Aye.
Nine ayes.
Motion passes. Item 5.2 is RC number 90 of 2021 by the Public Works Committee, to whom was referred resolution number 51 of 2021 by Alderperson Sorensen, authorizing the appropriate city officials to accept two grants from the restoration of our tree Sheboygan roots regarding the emerald ash borer mitigation at the city parks, and recommends adopting the resolution. Alderperson Sorensen.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to receive the report of the committee and adopt the resolution.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. That motion is before you. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Alderperson Bourne?
Aye.
Alderperson Flicky-Pineski?
Aye.
Nine ayes.
Motion passes. Item 5.3 is RC number 91 of 2021 by the Public Works Committee, to whom was referred resolution number 52 of 2021 by Alderperson Sorensen and Decker, authorizing the appropriate city officials to execute a memorandum of understanding with Acuity regarding the terms and conditions of the driveway improvements off of Indiana Avenue related to infrastructure associated with Acuity's expansion and Advocate Aurora's hospital project. Recommends adopting the resolution with amendments to change Indiana Avenue to Union Avenue. Alderperson Sorensen.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to receive the report of the committee and adopt the substitute resolution.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on the motion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Alderperson Bourne?
Aye.
Alderperson Flicky-Pineski?
Aye.
Nine ayes.
Motion passes. Item 5.4 is RC number 92 of 2021 by the Finance and Personnel Committee, to whom was referred direct referral resolution number 54 of 2021 by Alderpersons Donahue and Boren, resolving support of federal economic stimulus investments in water restoration priorities for the Great Lakes coastal communities. Recommends adopting the resolution and directing the city clerk to send copies to our congressional representatives and the United States senators representing the city of Sheboygan. Alderperson Donahue.
Thank you. I move to receive the report of the committee and adopt the resolution.
Second, Foreign.
Thank you for that motion. Is there any discussion on the motion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Alderperson Bourne?
Aye.
Alderperson Flicky-Pineski?
Aye.
Nine ayes.
Motion passes. Item 5.5 is RC number 93 of 2021 by the Finance and Personnel Committee, to whom was referred direct referral resolution number 55 of 2021 by Alderpersons Donahue and Boren, authorizing the appropriate city officials to execute a vacant land offer to purchase with Martin's Trilling True Value Hardware, and recommends adopting the resolution. Alderperson Donahue.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to receive the report of the committee and adopt the resolution.
Second, Foreign.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll?
Alderperson Bourne?
Aye.
Alderperson Flicky-Pineski?
Aye.
Nine ayes.
Motion passes. Under general ordinances, item 6.1 will be referred to the Finance and Personnel Committee. Under items for discussion only, item 7.1 is a discussion regarding land located in the Sheboygan Business Park, term parcel 59284790 85. For this, I'd like to call on Planning Director Chad Pelichek for some comments.
Thank you, Mayor. So this item was in the closed session at the Finance and Personnel Committee last Monday, and after some technical difficulties of going back on in open session, this document was never moved forward. So at this time, this is to sell a parcel of land in the current Sheboygan Business Center to Torgonol for a future expansion of their facilities off of Barron's Parkway. It's a roughly 8.7 acre parcel with a value of around $187,000. Given the way it's on the agenda for discussion only, I'm happy to answer any questions from the council, but I think at this stage I will give the Torgonol, have them submit an offer to purchase that the council can take up at a later date.
Thank you for that information. Does anyone have any questions for Chad on this issue? Very good. Move on to other matters authorized by law. Let's call on City Attorney Charles Adams.
The only other item is an RO by the city clerk submitting various license applications for the period ending December 31, 2020, June 30, 2021, and June 30, 2020.
Thank you. And that would be referred to the Licensing Hearings and Public Safety Committee. There's no need for a closed session tonight, so I call on Alderperson Sorensen.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to adjourn.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and second to adjourn. All those in favor of adjournment, please signify by saying aye.
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 Aye. Aye.